What's up, Hedgehog Maniacs and Doki Fanatics? Sonic17 here, back with more Doki Doki Exit Music Redux, which is a mod for Doki Doki Literature Club and a retelling of the original Exit Music mod. The last time you saw me play, MC went back into his bedroom for the first time since. I can't bring myself to say it. But when he went in there, he found a note that was left beside his closet. It was Natsuki's suicide note. I just said it there, but when he got done reading it, felt like it was time for him to take his own life. Sayori tried to talk him out of it, but it was no good. That's how the story ended, but as you saw before my video ended, there was a bonus. I'll show it to you. We got parallels and alternatives. You're about to see the first parallel. Time to dive in, and let's do it to it. Parallel 1. Street Spirit. Thursday, September 28th, 2017. Huh? What's this? Are we in MC's perspective? Are we in somebody else's perspective? Because I see Sayori on the screen. What's this? If you hear any other background noises, it's my heater. There's nothing I can do about that, so I apologize for that. But anyway, I blink once, twice, thrice. I try to process what she said. Suicide. Wait. Suicide. Wait a minute. Whose perspective is this? Is this Monica's? Puzzle clicks into place. Her behavior. Her absence. Is this Monica's perspective? It's not MC. It is not MC. This must be Monica's perspective. Or maybe Natsuki's perspective. Or even Yuri. I don't know. Sanjax's reactions and excuses. He tried to cover it up as best he could. A project success. Oh, wait. Wait a minute. It's not Monica. So it's not MC, it's not Monica, and it's not Sayori because she's on screen. Is it Natsuki or is it Yuri's perspective?
Partial success. Monica had no idea, at least.
Or is it Yuri? I don't know. I figure it might be something like this. Oh, she's staring. I should say something. It's Yuri! It's Yuri's perspective! Last time I was in Yuri's perspective for a mod, it was DDLC Storm! Wow! I was not expecting to be Yuri's perspective. Alright. Yeah. Why can't I say something, anything of substance? I don't know. Sayori looks at me blankly, but for a moment, Oh, Sayori. She quietly giggles. Laughing?
Oh no!
I have to apologize, right now! Do it! I'm so sorry, Yuri. That was so...
What? Uh-huh. You're fine. I was just thinking, if everyone's reaction is gonna be like that, then today's gonna be a heck of a lot easier than I thought!
This must be when... Before MC... Natsuki and Monica came to the club that day when Sayori explained why she was absent. That was something that I alluded to earlier in Act 1. Interesting. Anyway.
I apologize. I...
No. I actually really appreciate it. The low-key response, I mean. You were going into, like, freakout mode. That's what I was afraid of.
Afraid of? You are afraid of others' reactions? She nods.
It's just because... You need to tell people, sure, but... Nobody needs to worry about me other than me, you know? It just made me feel worse. Though that ruined someone else's day. I can handle my own issues. And the less people who worry, the better. Does that make sense?
The statement strikes a chord. The feeling of which I know all too well. Scarred flesh on my arm seems to pulsate with my heartbeat, providing a burning, familiar itch. A problem that she is at war with inside her head, manifesting into the physical. Something deep within feels elated. I'm not alone. But do I? I find my mouth opening before I can think. I can sympathize in more ways than one. Do I do this?
What are you thinking, Yuri? And Sayori's asking that same question too, in her head.
Is this even appropriate? Sayori is a friend, granted, but with how she opened up just now? I glance over at her. As I find me her eyes, that same something deep within emerges once more. I decide to finally connect with someone who can understand. Someone who's also been at the blackest brink. Someone who know not to go into hysterics at the mere mention. A friend. If it's anybody, can I be confident in your discretion?
I don't think Sayori understands that word.
What?
I meant, can you keep a secret between us?
Oh, yeah, of course!
Yeah, that's part of it that even Sayori can understand. Sorry to you all Sayori fans out there.
It's okay to be vulnerable. I breathed in. This will help her. I think.
Hope you're right.
You're aware that I have a sizable collection of knives, yes?
Yeah, the car knives!
Yes, those. They're not entirely for decoration.
I know where this is going.
I swallow my own uncertainty and mentally piece together my response. I keep them sharp and clean.
because sometimes I'll nick the blade into my skin.
Yeah, I think we all know about that, but this is news to Sayori as far as this mod goes.
Enough to draw blood! I'm long past the point of no return. In for a penny, in for a pound. I used to do this on my arms, but they're too noticeable. I didn't want anybody to see them. I still don't. So, I switched to the top of my thighs. I try to keep it under control, and I'm managing a lot better now. But I used to think that was all because of anxiety or some sort of fetish. And now, I think somewhere inside, subconsciously, I wish to feel pain.
And she's crying.
I can't say I particularly enjoy the sensation. Quite the opposite, in fact. But it's as if I deserve to feel it anyway. Sayori remains quiet, arms folded in her lap, gazing forward at her shoes. I went too far. I ruined it. I didn't mean to make this all about myself. I thought I'd tell you because you might feel similarly. Perhaps you might find some comfort in the fact that you're not alone. That you aren't alone in the way you're feeling, I meant. And that everything changes eventually. Not always for the better, but things can change. It's the nature of life itself. When you sought out the help you needed, it was the first step to that change. And it's something to look forward to. I think that the only comfort I can provide, without lying to you, I run out of figurative steam, pausing myself before I trail off into nonsense. Sayori takes a deep breath.
Yeah, she's...
I feel her arms wrapped around me. My nerves recoil at the sudden touch, and I really consider backing away. But I think she needs this.
Yeah, she does.
And for once, my touch, my pulsation softened. We stay like this for a minute or two before I feel her pull back. She speaks up.
Thank you. That could have been easy for you to talk about.
It wasn't.
That's an understatement.
I'm sorry.
Please, don't be. I don't imagine yours was any easier. Looks down at her feet, clacking her shoes together aimlessly for a moment. Her hands lie limp in her lap.
It still hurts. It hurts every time to think about it and talk about it. Today's gonna be today is going to hurt a lot. But my friends deserve to know.
When are you planning on telling them?
Maybe as soon as everyone gets here. Even though I know people like you and subjects are gonna be supportive of it, none of that makes me any less worried.
Yeah, so basically, right now, at this point with this parallel, MC and Yuri know about Sayuri's condition, but Natsuki and Monica do not. When there's any more to this parallel, or that's gonna end it. Let's see.
Well,
Well, I just want to let you know. I'll be there for you. Sayori hides her emotions well, most of the time. I'm sure nobody was aware of what was going on beneath the surface. But even I can see how she's feeling now. That feeling primarily being shielded under dread. I can tell from her expression, her eyes shrunk to what seems to have no end, her mouth quivering into a frown. Knowing that my attempt at comforting her somewhat failed miserably, I steel myself and attempt again. Listen. You don't have to listen to me or anyone else about what to do. But no matter what, just know that whatever you choose is entirely up to you.
Exactly, Yuri. Words to live by.
Her eyes closed for a moment.
What? Yeah, it is. And it feels good. But...
She turns towards me again.
Things can change. Things can change.
They always can, whether by your own forces or those outside us. A small nod from her. Then a sign.
That's a nice start. Cause like, you can't sign X. I feel like sign X. They haven't even seen this before. And they're just...
I forgot about Sayori's mother. So up to that point... Yeah, as I was saying. MC... Yuri and Sayori's mother know about Sayori's condition.
I see what it was. Like I'm a nutcase or something. And I'm not, like, fine, but I'm doing better. Like, somewhere in the middle, you know? I hope they'll change something soon.
I suppose that makes two of us, then. A small smile escapes her as she turns her head to meet my gaze once more. I instinctively evade eye contact.
Guess so!
The assured silence envelops us. There's a dark feeling brewing beneath, but I swallow it back down. I can't let down my demeanor in front of her, in front of anyone! I will handle it later. Right now, I need to say something. I attempt once again to provide some level of comfort. We haven't kept in good contact as of late, have we?
Yeah, we haven't. I'm bad at the whole responding to people's messages thing. I still appreciate the way you sent me though. I don't know that.
Oh, Sayori.
Well, don't worry about that for now. I don't find myself initiating much conversation, truth be told. Sometimes I don't even remember my phone exists. But I always have it on, so... You can always reach out to me if you need something. I may not respond all the time, but... I am but a measure away. Take my phone out and gently wave it.
Oh, Sayori.
As soon as I do, Sayori snorts and laughs loudly.
Yeah, you're that dinosaur.
What?
2005 gone. He wants his phone back.
Oh, wait. Does this mean Yui has a flip phone? Ain't that something? Wow.
I can't believe you still own a flip phone.
Called it.
I didn't even use that thing.
It's affordable and reliable. I have no need for a touchscreen or constant internet access.
Speak for yourself, Yuri.
What?
Okay, that's surprising. That's surprising, Sayori, right there.
How did I go blind? I go crazy.
Yeah, I'm with you on that one, Sayori. I think everybody else would agree on it. Well, most people. Anyway.
I do nothing but simply tap my open bag, where the black cover of the Portugal Markov protrudes.
Right. Yeah, I try my best with that stuff. It's just so easy to stay on my phone all the time and endlessly scroll.
It's a massive time sink, you know? A constant distraction.
But Yuri! There's so many cats!
Oh, man. But honestly, this is what I need right now after that ending with in the main story. But I'm wondering how the alternates and the other parallels are going to go. Anyway.
I'm no Luddite, Sayori. I have a laptop at home. But I find that a smartphone takes up a lot of time and energy. Hence why I try to avoid it. It's not really healthy to...
I think it's the others.
A car from the front of the room startles me.
Oh, it's a Yix!
Oh! Wow! CMC! Wow! I gotta say, he looks good in this mod.
Startled. I look up to see Sadiak sheepishly waving, setting down his bag. How long was he there for?
It was Natsuki. Just good to see her again.
He's followed by Natsuki, who seems to be around her school blazer. Curious. I quickly head back to my desk by the corner, stuffing my bag beneath my arm.
How long have you been here?
Just arrived. Everything okay?
I don't respond. A wave of shame washes over me. I didn't even greet Sign X or Natsuki. Why am I always like this? Always unable to strike up a conversation.
Wait, is it starting to blow again?
Sayori even had to push me to talk to her today. I'm glad we did. I still feel a bit better about my own issues. But I feel so tired, fatigued, drained. I feel eyes staring at me. I don't dare look back, instead pulling out the Portugal mark guard from my bag. Natsuki waves to Sayori before disappearing into the closet.
Yeah, everything's good.
While trying to find my place, I sneak a glance in front of the room. San Yex and Sayori seem to be in a quiet conversation. I wonder if he knows the extent of what Sayori's internal turmoil truly is. A silly thought in retrospect. He has to know. At least, on some sort of level. Either way, it's up to Sayori now. I think she'll end up following through with her plan. But the emotional response from the rest of our members... My muscles tense up again. Part of me wants to be there as a show of support. But I think back to what Sayori told me, about how she just wants us to move past it. Perhaps it's better if I stay here. If she needs me, I have no doubts that she'll let me know. Until then, I need to limit my involvement. Lest I induce a stress headache or worse, a panic attack.
Sheesh.
That's the last thing any of us needs right now. Keep calm and read my book. I I tune the world out, relax my muscles, breathe. Let the words flow through me. Now, where was...
There was Monica, right on cue.
Marcus' sudden appearance at the door wrenches me out of my meditation. Her voice is loud and demanding, startling me enough to snap me out of my thoughts. It means it's about to start. If it starts, I feel that creeping tension once more. A feeling of breathing in humid air on this hot, sunless day. Faint trembling in my fingers.
Actually, Marco, I think it'll be easy to just address it now.
Yeah, this is where Sayori reveals the whole... Well, Sayori reveals it. But during that time, it was in MC's perspective. I wonder if it's going to be more from Yuri's perspective.
I hear Monica talking. That's Sanya X. Then Sayori interrupts. I see Natsuki slink away. Then Monica again. My hyper-awareness is like a radio that I can't turn off. Should I be up there? Should I keep away? What am I expected to do? I don't know! I try to focus myself once more to ease my mind back into the page. Slow breaths. In. Out. Once more, the world is blocked out, and I slip into my trance.
Huh? What's going on here? Whoa. What's this?
A sudden sound to my left. I gasp and jerk my head around.
Whoa. Yeah, realize Natsuki is taken aback. She is shocked by what Sayori said.
Natsuki, eyes wide and skin pale, has taken a seat at a corner desk. I make eye contact with Sayori. Her expression is... I stand up and head towards Natsuki. Why am I doing this?
You need to come... Something tells me you're gonna come for her, Yuri. You need to.
I'm so drained! Exhausted! That talk with Sayori depleted any energy I had for social interactions today. Besides, deep inside, I'm scared that she will yell at me.
That's a possibility, but still.
That she will not want me around. But... Natsuki is my friend. She at least needs to know I care. Without attracting too much attention, I creep my way towards Natsuki in a half crouch.
Crouch? Half crouch. Yeah. Duh.
I kneel down next to her. She doesn't seem to acknowledge me. Natsuki? She opens her eyes, staring me down. Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I doubt you.
That's Natsuki for you. She acts tough, but from the way she is right now, I think she's still shocked by it.
I doubt that she's at all fine. Even so, you can... I trail off. What am I even doing? I'm already overextending it as it is. I'm making a fool out of myself.
Thanks, I guess. And yeah, it's nice of you. And yeah, now I'm good. It's every stop. I can handle it on my own.
Seriously?
As long as you're sure, then I'll let you be. But the offer always stands. You have my number, I think.
I don't know. I might. I mean, I could just get offside the X either way if I need to.
I see.
I think it's that at that point I think Natsuki still has a phone at this time.
I'm sorry to bother you. I can feel the animosity. Doubtless she still carries some level of grudge for the things I said previously.
Probably when Amp doing that argument that about MC liking both of their poems.
I've got my message across. I came off as still and unnatural, but that's a secondary concern. I can only nod awkwardly and stand up to leave. I feel a hand grasp my forearm.
Yuri, wait!
Hmm? What's this? I pause and kneel back down.
Can't you just stay here for a second?
Oh, of course.
Just... yeah.
There's a lot of emotions right now.
We're there in silence for a minute or two. Natsuki boring holes into the desk with her stare. Myself beside her as silent company. If anything, this has got my mind away from what's happening in front of the room. Though, I do worry about how Sayori is doing. And a part of me wonders how Sanyex, so confident up confident up until now, is handling this news. Likely better than I am, though that's not precisely a high bar.
True.
I find myself scratching my arm nervously. Turning around, I see Sayori sitting at her desk, writing something down in her notebook. Out of the corner of my eye, I can see the faint shape of Sanyex approaching down the aisles of desks. Satisfied that Natsuki won't be alone, I nod to Sanyex and head towards Sayori.
So basically, at that point, MC is comforting Natsuki about the whole thing now. If I recall correctly. Anyway.
I feel slightly better talking to her. I think I salvaged that moment with Natsuki, but I can't take much more risk today. I take a seat next to Sayori.
Hey, Sayori!
Her shoulders sag, and she doesn't look at me. I take the conversation didn't fare well.
It was just what needed to be said. Nothing else.
She sniffs and wipes her eyes with her sleeve. Would you like some company? I can't exactly talk too much right now, but... Sayori seems to look past me, towards Sanyex and Natsuki, before going back to her notebook.
Yeah! I need to jot some notes down! Notes for my therapy! So I'll be quiet anyway!
I nod and quietly move my desk closer to her. I open my book once again.
Thanks, Yuri, for being here.
It's no problem. Her presence allows my stress to slowly melt away. A mutual understanding between us, a shared struggle, provides an odd form of comfort. I find myself falling into my book, much easier this time. And for the first time today, I find a moment of peace.
So there's more. This is interesting.
So that's what happened to the prisoners. That's inhuman. Grisly. It makes me ponder about some of the more memorable aspects of my history lessons.
Wait, is this Monica or is it still Yuri?
I can only ponder is that my thought is interrupted by Sayori prodding me on the arm.
Yeah, it's still Yuri.
Hey, Yuri, before we go!
She looks away and shakes her head.
Oh! Need to be alone for a while. Sayori's probably taking this kind of hard. I know they've been hanging out a lot recently. If that goes without him, would you be able to walk him home?
Instantly, my limbs seize up. I've become a somewhat sense earlier, but this is so sudden. You want me to?
It doesn't pay, I promise.
But
I know this isn't really done yet, Addy. Don't be worried. It's a big thing to ask. I know that I wouldn't. But right now, I just need to go home and scrub this all out.
I find myself torn. I can't let Sayori down. Not today. But I don't know if I can handle this. I could try.
That's all I ask. Thanks, Yuri. I owe you a big one.
What if?
It's not hard. Just make some conversation. You don't have to do anything.
She picks up her bag, slinging it over her shoulder. Like what?
I mean, Yuri, anything. You know, it's along with whatever I talk about half the time.
She glances at her phone.
Close mouth to end. Can I see your mind? No, it's okay. Then I'm out.
Okay. Take care, won't you?
Of course. I'll be fine. Don't worry about me.
She sneaks one last glance at Sonya X before heading over to Monica's desk. As I'm putting away my book, I can only think about my task ahead.
Oh boy. And I thought Yuri being stressed out at DDLC Storm was bad enough.
Why am I like this? It seems that it's the third time I've had to ask this question today. As if I have an answer beyond I'm abnormal. And the fact that I'm attracted to him. No, that's not helping.
Oh, so Yuri does have feelings for MC in this mod. Wow. So, I'm kind of surprised with that, honestly. Because she didn't try anything in the Redux, in the main story. Man. Kind of surprising, honestly, but anyway.
No, that's not helping. I need to keep a cool head. I'm doing this for Sayori. Sonyx is a friend. Talk to him like Sayori. If I can handle that today. I see him staring at the cup into the cupboard. How am I even supposed to initiate conversation? I guess I could just walk up and ask. I slowly make my way over to him. He seems to be breathing hard. Is he okay? Sonny X? He doesn't respond. I strain myself to speak a bit louder. Sonny X?
Eh?
Oh. He snaps out of his stare. Only now do I notice that his hands gripping the desk in front of him, their knuckles white. Did I cause this? I didn't mean to startle you.
Oh, don't worry, you didn't. I was just trying to, you know what? Never mind. What's up?
I forced myself to speak. Well, I was just wondering if you would like to walk home together? I just noticed how Sayori and you walk home a lot, and was wondering if you want to since, you know. Hopefully he doesn't see my apprehension or my lies.
Sure, that'd be nice actually.
If he noticed, he didn't bring it up. Thank God. With that out of the way, I try to sound energetic. Oh, great. Let me pick up my things. Perhaps that was a little too energetic. I grab my bag and follow Sonyx out of the club room. Before we leave, I wave to Monica, who seems to have slumped down into the teacher's chair. I feel terrible for leaving her here. I'll ask how she's doing tomorrow. Entering into the corridor, we navigate the halls quietly. But just as I'm entering my trance, Sonyx speaks up.
So,
an awkward pause. The familiar feeling of tensing up creeps back. I know Sari said he listens to anything, but I wonder if I inadvertently putting him on the spot by not being a conversationalist. Trying to muster up energy to bring up a topic, my throat just closes instead. Thankfully, Sonyx breaks the silence with some refreshing honesty.
Sorry, I don't really know what to talk about.
Seems like it's up to me. Topics. Looking for anything but the obvious, I come up short. Maybe we should discuss earlier.
I'd rather not.
Too soon?
Yeah.
And yet again, I made a fool out of myself. I squeeze out an apology. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. I just don't want to talk about it right now.
That's understandable. I was just concerned as to how Sayori is feeling. I mean, I know how she's handling her emotions, but I wanted to discuss it more with someone who knows her more than I. But I'm not sure if that's proper of me, or if that's too invasive.
Oh, I think she's doing better now than it's out there.
I nod in agreement. As we enter the courtyard, the trickling sound of the fountain echoes off the walls and creates a cacophony.
Sorry if I can't pronounce that right.
It feels like it surrounds me. I always appreciate that about this place. When it's quiet, anyway. Sonyx seems to look at the fountain with a painful expression, before turning to me suddenly.
You're a very mysterious person, you know?
That was unexpected. I try to stammer out an appropriate response. Eh? Oh. Do you think that's a bad thing? For all I know, it could be. I keep myself secluded for a reason. Socializing drains me like nothing else. It's not anyone's fault, it's just how it is. What if it's driving them away?
I mean, not really. I just don't really know what you like beyond the horror novels and tea. I suppose that's purely my fault for not reaching out to you.
The blame's not just on you, Sanyex. I could be opening up. I take a deep breath and take Sayori's advice. You just have to be honest. Well, not really. I like to keep myself fairly secluded. That includes my personal life and any hobbies I take part in. Even my friends, like Sayori, don't know much about me outside of school. That's deliberate. It seems to leave Sinex ruminating for quite a while. I appreciate the silence, though I can't help but be worried if I had intimidated him. Against my better judgment, I try to reassure and refocus. I just feel safer being alone, if that makes any sense.
Yeah, you're the one who invited me on a walk.
Oh. Well, it wasn't a time of my own volition. But yes, he has a point, and a frustrating one at that. I do wish to be alone most of the time. But without the connections I have, I don't know where I'd be. The ones I care for the most, they don't sap my energy as much. Sinex seems to be included amongst that group too, judging by the fact that I haven't clammed up by now. Well, you're different. Kinda like Sayori. I don't know. I just feel more comfortable around you.
Oh boy, he's blushing.
Where am I even going with this? It's weird. I'm sorry for bringing it up.
No, it's fine.
I just feel like I can let my guard down more when you're around. I like that. I'm sorry. I must sound crazy.
I have all the things that happened this week. This is probably the most normal moment I've had. So, no.
That's reassuring. But I'm glad.
Hey. I'm glad for the company. Maybe the same walking home alone again. Which, speaking of, you said Sayori is someone else you're comfortable with?
Yes. She's been a good friend lately. Very approachable. I suppose it's a good way of putting it. And an apt listener. Something you two have in common, it looks like. I am sorry if I rambled on too much.
Not at all! And yeah, Sayori is a good friend. Natsuki has been too.
Just a friend? God, why am I being so invasive? I noticed the two of you have gotten close lately. I'm sure Monica's glad everyone's getting along. Well, most of us.
Hey, look, I doubt Natsuki hates you.
You're just very different people, different hobbies and interests. She's also very open and direct about what she likes, and you keep things bottled down deep. Close to the chest?
Yeah, that.
I really do need to reach out to her more. When I saw her on...
Oh no! Oh no!
Why did my tongue slip?
Wait. Was it something on Tuesday? I don't know. What's going on? What?
Nothing.
Did you see us on Tuesday? Oh. Uh-oh.
Okay, Yuri. Just own up to it. Be honest. Maybe he'll forgive you for shoving your nose where it doesn't belong. I didn't know it was the both of you. Please don't be angry.
No. Yuri, you're fine. Don't worry about it.
I'm fine? Can I just ask away?
Yeah, we saw each other Tuesday. She didn't want to come inside the club room.
Why not?
I guess she felt guilty. Thought you and Monica would be mad at her.
Monica, maybe a little, but I was just glad she was okay. I made sure Monica didn't know. I think she would chase Natsuki down the halls and worry.
Yeah, probably. I was able to calm her down eventually, though.
Huh? Why would she be calm? Did the stress from us potentially being mad at her really get to her that much? I'd be surprised if it did. To my eye, Natsuki's always been hardy and unaffected by others' opinions.
Well, yes and no.
What do you mean?
One of her family members had a stroke.
Oh, goodness!
You can tell FC, by the way FC is, he did not want to say that. Because he knew something more serious was going on at the time.
Oh my! I'm so sorry!
It's fine. I think she said that they'll do it better now.
You're a kind person, Sayex. I know that out of anyone you'll be able to comfort Natsuki during this. I know that out of anyone to be able to comfort Natsuki during this, it's you. She's a good friend, even if we fight.
Yeah.
Two of us turned onto a nearby street, heeding the pedestrian crossing. Just about to cross, Sadiak snatches my arm to stop me.
Hey, Yuri.
Mm-hmm.
Do you mind if we take an alternate route?
For what purpose? The only alternate route is to the left, and... Following Sanyex's gaze, I catch a glimpse of a group of students loudly outside a corner shop.
Oh. I just know you don't like crowds too much, and well, I'm not really in the mood right now.
Why is he so kind and open? I probably would have gone the other way on my own, but I appreciate the suggestion. Remember what Sayori said. Talk to him like a friend. Well, thank you for your consideration. In that case, we'll go the alternate path. Here. I lead him down the side alley to our left. The path takes us into a small suburb. Much quieter, much safer. I breathe a silent sigh of relief. Before said relief is interrupted by Sadiak blurring something out.
Wait, no way! I remember this! My parents used to take me out this way when I was young. There's a playground on the other side here, down the hill, I think, where me and Sayori used to play. You walk this road every day?
Not every day. When it's necessary.
It's a good spot. Sayori would love it here.
She does, in fact. I showed her this spot a long while ago. Memories of the bakery.
Huh? Oh boy.
The sickly sweet smell of sugary treats. The inhalation of chocolate croissants. Sayori's choice, of course.
Oh, Sayori.
And warm. So warm. Hopefully she remembers. hope she thinks as fondly of that day as I do. It ranks highly in mine. Gosh, that's kind of pathetic when I think about it. Kubikui is one of my crowning memories from this past year. Why can't I just engage in more social activities with everyone? That's the normal way. You're not normal, Yuri. You're weird. You're mysterious. You're pretentious. And you have to accept that. You have to own it. God, why can't I get out of my own head? I hate this. Just talk to Sonyx. Sonyx will make it all okay. God, now he's laughing. Laughing at me? Something funny? Do I laugh too? I offer a weak giggle. Sonyx turns to me, confused. Uh-oh. I take you enjoying the walk?
Yeah, actually.
It's much more nice than I thought it was gonna be. I knew it. Or, well, he thought he hated it, but he doesn't. I struggle to get a read on his meaning. Oh? Did you not think it was going to be nice? What? No! Oh, thank goodness.
Well, I mean, yes. You know what I mean.
I think I do. I think he's just as worried as I am. It brings me a small comfort. We're both just as intimidated of each other. But we're talking frequently, enjoying the evening sun, the pleasant sights and sounds, in a place where I feel safe. This isn't so bad after all. Yes, what do you think? I always enjoy going the scenic route, especially down here. I've taken Sayori down this path, now Sonyx. While I was at admittedly easier with Sayori, as she always had something to talk about, I begin to rather enjoy Sonyx's more reserved presence. I don't feel as pressured to talk about something. It's easier to let silence fill the void between our thoughts and musings. I could get used to this. He mentioned that playground earlier. Perhaps I could point that out to him. Oh, by the way, the playground you mentioned is over there, down that other road.
Wow, that's a blast from the past.
I bet it was. Childhood friendships wasn't something I had the pleasure of experiencing often. I know you met Monica in my early teens, and had really nobody else before then.
Well, this mod did say at the start that this was created before the announcement of DDLC Plus.
I was just as reclusive then as I am now. And only now I'm realizing that I missed out on making some valuable memories. I'm glad you enjoyed yourself this much.
Me too.
But it's always as good to make some new memories instead. I intend to be more daring and strike up a new conversation. Come to think of it, how are your walks home usually?
Well, they're alright.
They're made a whole lot better when I'm walking with Sayori. She seems to just lighten up everything wherever she goes. I don't know how she does it. It's just... It hasn't been the same for a while.
Just like that, we're back to discussing Sayori. As affected as we all are by her confession, I couldn't begin to imagine the hurt Sonyx is going through right now. He's already been stressed about Natsuki, and to finally have this bombshell flung into the works? God, he must be absolutely devastating. Devastating. Especially since he's only just found out after all this time?
I don't know. Things are changing so fast. Sayori and I were close friends. And Natsuki and I got really close too. But now Sayori is, you know. And Natsuki has her own problems. It's like life slammed on the gas pedal and I'm just along for the ride. Walking home alone used to clear my head. Now from the events of just 1 week, I don't know.
It appears to have affected him as badly, if not worse, as I first started. There has to be some sort of way to comfort him in this time of stress. Then all of a sudden, my memory flashes me back to what he said and the advice I gave to Sayori. Things are changing really fast. Things change. I can understand why you feel overwhelmed. Life throws a curveball, and you find yourself having to adapt under pressure. It's a major adjustment to make, having to think on one's feet. An encroachment upon your comfort zone, and what you deem normal. Stable, safe. I recently had that happen to me with Sayori. I nod. She explained everything to me before the club meeting started. It made sense, given what facts I knew, but
it didn't change how you felt?
No.
I get it. I didn't really know how to react. With how Natsuki has been feeling as well, it hit me like a 1-2 punch. And I don't know how to deal with it. It's not like anyone gets an instruction manual with life.
I love that expression.
I just don't know how I can help them.
I think the best you can do is be supportive and fashion.
A what?
It means a hands-off approach. Giving room, but be present. Does that make sense?
I don't know about that.
I feel like if I'm not around, something bad is going to happen. Things just constantly run through my head about what could be happening. At least if I'm there, I know if something's gone wrong, you know? Oh. No, this is way worse than I thought his mental state would be. But I still can't let him down like this. Not after him being so considerate towards me. He needs to deal with this in a healthy manner. I can't let him become like me!
Oh boy.
I wave off my thoughts and try to articulate a response. I simply try to tell him the truth, directly and honest. I am not sure if that's a healthy approach, Sayex. But you said something was wrong with Natsuki?
Yeah. She asked me to keep it on the down low, though.
I understand. I was just worried about her when she almost collapsed into a chair back in the club.
Oh. I think that what Sayori said just really got to her is all.
It did.
Oh yeah. You went to talk to her, right?
Yes. I've seen Natsuki upset many times, but that was different. She seemed scared. I tried to comfort her, but I'm not particularly adept with that.
Firstly, nonsense. You are a great listener. Secondly, yeah, she's plenty scared. I am too. About a lot of things.
I rack my brain for ways to try to help. And in doing so, I catch myself ignoring my own advice to Psy-X. It seems practicing a last-chance player approach is harder than it looks.
That was a hands-off experience. Anyway.
Alright. I'll be there for support should he need it. And I can't communicate that. But it'd be for the best to let him win his own battles. Right now, though, I need to focus on getting him home. Here, take him right across the street.
Yeah, this is looking familiar now.
You really should explore more, Sadiex. You might find shortcuts you never knew existed.
Yeah, or I could end up stabbed in a dark alley.
I didn't mean to go exploring downtown.
It's just a joke. There's barely any crime here. I'm gonna regret saying that.
If memory serves, Sayori said Sidex lives just to the right of her house. In which case, I see his house creeping into view. Thanks for suggesting the alternate route today.
Yeah, it's no problem.
I enjoyed it too. I think it really cleared my mind. And as you said, I'm really not in the mood for large crowds. Especially right now. They just make me...
anxious?
Like an open book. More or less. Fortunately for me, this mind isn't too difficult to decipher either. I know you must have had a problem with this as well.
Well, what's going on? Can you blame me?
No, not at all.
I found Sayori when she...
Oh, God! She told me what happened, but left out that detail.
So Yuri believed that MC found out about it at the same time as Natsuki and Monica. They had all that talk and everything, but when MC told Yuri about that, she was shocked. She found out that MC knew the day what it was gonna actually... You get what I'm saying, right?
That's horrible! I can only imagine the thought of it alone makes me dizzy. And I'm only hearing a second-hand account. So, Sanyex.
It really messed with me. That's all I really want to say right now.
Oh. I'm so sorry, Sidex. She didn't tell me it was you. That explains a lot. Are you doing all right now? That must have been extremely traumatic.
Don't worry about it. I'm okay.
I struggle not to worry about him more than I already have. Sayori's words echo back to me. I shake my head. He needed to let his feelings out, is all. He'll be okay. Still, to find such a close friend at their most vulnerable and hurt? I don't know if I'll be able to handle it. Lord only knows how he can. I need a quiet place to think. The hyper-awareness sneaks back in, foreshadowing the anxiety that is to come. I like Sidex, but I hope this ends soon. Speaking of, Sidex seems to be walking at a slightly slower pace than before now. Which is most likely because...
Well, this is my place.
Ah, I see. It hadn't even occurred to me until a second ago. Stuck in my own head again. I try to draw out conversation. I try to draw our conversation to a satisfactory close. Well, this was nice.
Yeah, it was.
It's far from original, but I don't think Sadiek's minds. From the sound of things, he needs some time to unwind. Again, thank you for the alternate route. I quite enjoyed it.
Me too.
What am I even doing? I have to offer some support. No, all the support I have. But can I? I'm just going to mess up like I always do. I can't be like this right now. Not when a friend of mine is desperately in need. God, does he have my number? Yeah, Natsuki said he does. Okay. I need to let him know that I'm here for him. Now! Just to let you know, if you ever want to talk, why can't I get the words out? I was just fine with Sayori. Always able to talk in the club? No! I want to offer him a text or something. Anything of more substance than that. I'm such an idiot. I knew I couldn't do it.
Thanks, Yuri. It means a lot. Really.
I tore my head away to mask the embarrassment. I try to offer him a smile anyway. I need to get away from here. I could try another time. Just need to prepare for it. Maybe I could send him a text when I get home. Yeah, a text. Well, thank you for this. Today, I mean.
Hey, it's nothing.
It's getting late. My parents won't like it, but I'll message them. I should be home by supper, so it should be a catastrophe. My apologies, but I must go now.
No. You're good. Have a nice day.
Thank God he isn't asking why I'm leaving so abruptly. I take a small and hopeful and noticeable sign of relief. You too. Sanyx turns away and heads towards his front door. I walk at a slow pace away for a moment before stopping next door.
Is she going to talk to Sayori?
For a moment, I think about knocking, but I hesitate. I need to think. I need time alone. If Sayori can handle herself, I hold my bag close to my chest and briskly walk down the street, sitting down at a bus station. The events of the day play back through my head, and I barely remember even boarding the bus.
Hello! So this must be Yuri's bedroom. Interesting.
I draw my bag onto my floor. I'm usually organized. My bag hung up neatly for the next day. I can't care about that right now. I take off my blazer and it too ends up on the floor. I don't care. I sit on my bed and hold my head in my hands. The events have not stopped replaying in my head. How could I have reached out to Sanyx beyond the token attempt if I wasn't such an idiot? How could I have been closer to Sayori if I wasn't better at being social? How could I have asked Monica how Monica was feeling if I wasn't so focused on Sanyx's well-being? How I almost lost a close friend. I kept my feelings withheld to provide my usual stoic demeanor. But I can't anymore. I gently fall sideways onto my bed, bringing my knees to my chest. Huh? I close my eyes as everything floods back. Everything I could have said and done. Everything I almost lost. The inevitable feeling that I can't do anything to prevent it. And the dread that something even worse will happen. My inner wall collapses. A tear falls across the bridge of my nose onto my pillow. Then another.
Oh man. Whoa. Man. Wow. So that was Street Spirit, Hedgehog Maniacs. Man. This is gonna be... That was something to say the least, wasn't it? I mean... It was basically like what happened when Sayori revealed to the rest of the club members about her condition and everything. But it was from Yui's perspective and all that. That's interesting. Wow. I gotta say, this is getting more interesting by the minute. I wonder whose perspective it's gonna be when I do the next parallel. Won't know till I do it. But for now, SideGeek17 is signing out. I'll catch you guys in the next video. I'll see you guys later. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and let me know what you think down below. If you want to see more of my content, subscribe to me so you check out the rest of my content, and you also check out the videos you see here on the screen. I told you to stop doing that, Monica!